Action 2012 coverage now and a look at the 1st District Supervisor's race in Santa Cruz County. The district includes parts of Santa Cruz, Scotts Valley, and Capitola, as well as unincorporated areas of Live Oak and Opal Cliffs. Current incumbent John Leopold faces two challengers for the seat, Charles Paulden and Gary Richard Arnold. Action News reporter Tom Miller spoke with all three and brings us our report tonight.
The District 1 supervisor's race in Santa Cruz County is largely focused on protecting the coastline, a task incumbent John Leopold believes he's best suited to handle.
I also led the effort with neighbors who came to me around vacation rentals when they were overtaking our coastal neighborhoods, and we came up with a good policy that that resulted in $1 million in unpaid taxes coming to the county general fund, and that'll happen every year.
Leopold's most formidable challenge will likely come from environmental activist and yoga teacher Charles Paulden, who questions Leopold's commitment to preservation.
It's a lot more than sound bites and haircuts. It's about who we are, what we stand for. He says we have two different visions for the future. It's true. I see a future where we preserve our beautiful environment, where we have ecotourism, where we create jobs for our people, and not just turn into another random decaying city by the bay.
The third candidate in the race is Gary Richard Arnold, a talk radio personality who is described by his own former campaign manager as somewhat of a conspiracy theorist. He's concentrating on getting rid of what he calls a corrupt system.
Look at the endorsements these people have, and you turn the back of the brochure, and they're all endorsing each other. They're all padding the pensions. This is a machine in there. They've got it designed so that they're an elite that does not serve the people. Their policies, again, don't come internally at all.
Arnold's running on a platform that includes getting rid of smart meters, traffic cameras, and federal dollars going to local police departments.
We need police that are local and serve the people. What's happened here is they've been given Homeland Security money, and they've been nationalized. They have fusion centers in which they are now responsive to the national government instead of the people that they're supposed to be serving. And this way, I mean, this has happened in every dictatorship in the world, is the nationalization of the police.
Paulden is much more concerned with environmental issues like stormwater management and protecting the county's natural beauty.
I'm here to save paradise, not pay paradise. We have two visions of the future. One is a concrete urban jungle. One is a garden city that we want to live through and give to our future.
Current Supervisor Leopold talked about the widest range of issues, everything from redevelopment funds to boosting tourism. He's been called a career politician, and I asked him about bigger aspirations.
I grew up in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, and if you're a kid from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, and you end up living less than a mile away from the beach, representing a place called Pleasure Point, that's called making it. So I intend to do my service here and serve the community that I live in.
Whoever wins will represent the district with roughly 53,000 people in it. It includes the unincorporated areas of Live Oak, Soquel, Santa Cruz Gardens, Carbonero Estates, as well as the Summit area, and also parts of Capitola, Santa Cruz, and Scotts Valley. In the newsroom, I'm Tom Miller, KSBW Action News 8.